This is Jack from RCC Sport Bike, 517-925-8154. www.rccsportbike.com, m43powersports.com. I'm going to give you a breakdown of the modifications that were done to the B-King. Right now, the twin turbo system has been taken off for jet coating, and we're going to do a complete candy paint job on this, getting it ready for Daytona. Some changes that we made starting from the front of this bike is it's using a 21-inch front wheel. On sport bikes, 21-inch wheels are pretty much unheard of. A lot of work is involved when you get into a large wheel like that. 18s you can get to fit, 19s you could probably make some small mods and get to fit. 21, lots of clearance issues. And this particular one, using the Busa motor, the radiator was directly in the way of the back of the wheel and where the twin turbo setup was. To get more clearance and to run the tubing up into the plenum nice and clean, we got rid of the radiator and actually did a custom radiator in the tail. It's a custom made radiator. It's plenty large to take care of cooling this big motor, even if we get into temperatures that are 120 degrees outside. By doing that, you can see there was a twin turbo B-King that was made where the plumbing on it was pretty much all over the place. They stuck it right through the front of the intake tube here, which trying to hide everything and keep everything clean. When you got tubes wrapped around the bottom and up through the top of the rear air tubes, there's not very, I guess, anything clean about that at all. We're going through, we're gonna remove some of the frame mounts. We're gonna plug the holes and flush everything out because the frame and the complete body and graphic are gonna be all painted together. As you follow back on this, we haven't done it too much with the handlebars yet. We're gonna go through. The B-King uses a Kawasaki ZX14 style bezel on this side, so we're gonna do chrome bezels, right, left grips. We're gonna run straight handlebars, probably use a shorter kit from an M109R so we can run fat bars on it. And we'll probably retain the B-King reservoirs just because they are a little bit different than everything else out there in the market. Stock steering dampener is going to be kept, and with the rake and trail on this bike being changed so dramatically, the dampener hasn't really become an issue, but it's probably under high speed something that's a good idea to keep on there. This bike has potential for way over 500 horsepower. The motor's been completely built. We got H2O water injection in this ram air tube. And with the bike having front and rear air ride both, you can see that's your front shock. The compressors are in the left ram air duct, so we made use of those. We have dual switch with remote. These are my billet clear covers. For performance purposes, we're definitely gonna have to get rid of the clutch setup and go to a lockup. I got some clear covers being made up for this too, which you guys with boosters that are cutting fairings out may be interested in those also. This has Roaring Toys underbrace arm on it right now. We had a CNS single-sided tubular arm on it. We're going with Roaring Toys billet single-sided arm. Robert from Roaring Toys has always been there for us, helped us out with a lot of parts on this bike. We're using the four-piston upgrade setup with his bracket on it. Their arm, we modified a Busa OSD plate to fit a B-King where the pivot point is totally different, so we had to machine some parts. It wasn't something that was really that easy. This has Gill's rear sets on it, which we're going to be getting anodized to match the paint that we choose. RC Raven rotors, RC Raven wheels, Avon tires on the front, chrome caliper, four pistons that we sell here. If you guys need them for any of your radial mounts for Suzuki, M109 Gixxers, Busas, we have them here in stock. 249s retail on them. If you give me a call, especially if you're looking for a set, I can get them down for about $175. Has my clear stator cover on it with the matching six-finger design. I make the clutch cover to match this one also. Right now we're using an RIS adjustable chrome kickstand. We may go with something that matches more of a spike theme once we get the bolts and stuff replaced after the paint's done. A complete custom subframe was made for the rear to hold the radiator and to get a Gixxer 1000 tail on it. So this is a composite 8 over wide and Gixxer 1000 race tail on it. The B-King seat is the front. It's been split and welded with a Gixxer 1000 tail to make everything fit nice and clean and get that factory look. As I said before, we're on a 330 OSD, so we only have one chain running to the back. It's made it capable to keep it real short. This is a two-over Busa arm. We've made some modifications for the B-King so we could use the Busa arm. Shims have been made. B-Kings are rear exit exhaust. So the exhaust comes through the right side. The monoshock bolts right there. You can see this is a block that's been mounted to the old mount and then mounted back through the frame so we could run a Busa style dead in the middle rear air ride shock. It has my chrome reservoir and Brake Master on it. You can see it has a Kanji logo on the top. I do have caps that have an R on it or that are blank for you guys that are looking to put them on Gixxers and or maybe not have Kanji engraved Busa items on it. But there's been so many parts that have been made and modified for this bike. Well over 400 or 500 hours of labor in it. Labor hours would be in excess of probably $40,000 to $50,000 on top of the $60,000 in parts. So you're looking at a bike that is fairly plain right now, but the end all end is to produce something like this for a customer. You're going to be looking at close to $100,000. If you guys have custom ideas, give me a call, 517-925-8154. If you need parts for yourself or some ideas to know if they work, I can get you the answers and get you the right stuff to get your project on the road. M43powersports.com or call us 517-925-8154 and ask for Jack.